Hey everyone, and welcome to video 5 of the series in which we examine the lifecycle of writing and deploying a Chialisp smart coin. We're going to continue with our piggy bank example from the previous videos, but if you haven't seen those, that's actually okay for this video, because we're going to be talking about currying, which is one of the most important concepts to understand in order to take advantage of the unique features that Chialisp has over other blockchain programming languages. Put simply, currying is the practice of pre-committing to solution values. If we look at our piggy bank coin here, we had to define two constants that were specific to us when we wrote our coin: the target amount, or savings goal, and the cash out puzzle hash, or where the money goes once we have reached that goal. This certainly works, but what if somebody else wants to use this puzzle? They would have to copy our entire puzzle source, and then go in and manually change these values to be their own. Now, maybe you could live with this. I'm sure someone could write some software that would automate this away, but what if you were passed this module as an argument? Remember that puzzles are valid arguments in Chialisp too. Quite often you will have a puzzle as an argument, and your puzzle will actually want to set these constants during the execution of a spend. It can't set these as def constants during the spend, because the puzzle that is being passed in will be compiled, and there will be no way to know which values were constants and which values were just part of the program. The way that we solve this problem in Chialisp is by currying, which, as I said before, is the practice of pre-committing to solution values. We do this by including solutions as part of the puzzle. Let me go ahead and show you how that works. If I say some puzzle here, right? This is our entire Chialisp puzzle. We expect this to be run with some solution, right? What we're gonna do is we're gonna wrap this puzzle in A1. This means exactly the same thing as it did before. We're just saying run this puzzle with the entire solution. Remember that in CLVM, one means the entire solution. This is basically a no-op, but what it does allow us to do is it allows us to have the solution as part of our puzzle, and now we can manipulate it. What we're going to do is we're going to prepend an argument onto the solution. If we use C, the cons operator, we're going to go ahead and type target amount, and this will put whatever we fill in as target amount at the beginning of the solution. If we want to go ahead and do it with cash out puzzle hash as well, we just do it again. Now, when we take the tree hash of our puzzle, rather than just taking the hash of the puzzle that we had written in our file, we're going to take the hash of this puzzle, which is the puzzle that we wrote, but it's wrapped in this extra stuff that forces these arguments to be passed to the puzzle as part of the puzzle reveal. Let me go ahead and show you how we do this in Chialisp. Now, the Chialisp puzzle doesn't actually care about any of this. It is basically unaware of the concept of currying. All it wants to know is how many solutions am I getting and where do they go. If I go ahead and delete these, all we need to do is add target amount. We like to keep them capital to differentiate them from arguments that the spender is supposed to be passing in, and catch up puzzle hash. And that's it. We're just going to require two extra arguments, and then we're going to pass them into our puzzle just as we would everything else. But we're noting to the person who is solving this puzzle that you're not solving these arguments. You're only solving these ones. These ones are going to be hashed with the puzzle at the time of the coin creation. We, the puzzle maker, are making these arguments, not the solver. I'm going to go ahead and show you a couple of commands in the CDV toolkit now that will help you when you're doing currying. So let me go ahead and save this. And then what we're going to do is we're going to compile this project. Just like we did before, CDV CLSP build. We're going to specify the piggy bank file, and we're going to have it go ahead and build. It's going to begin the compilation. It should be pretty fast. It's not a big puzzle. There we go. And now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and take a look at the assembled CLVM. Right now, this is in hex format, and that's not very human readable. Not that CLVM is going to be either, but I want to highlight something. So if you use CDV CLSP disassemble, and then you specify the hex file, we can see this is the compiled CLVM version of our puzzle. Just two lines right here. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and run the curry command, which is going to allow us to do some currying before we make the puzzle. Curry. What I'm going to do is I'm going to specify the hex file. The reason is if we specify the Chialisp file, it will work, but it's going to compile it first. And if we specify the hex file, this is the already compiled version, so it'll just be a little bit faster. Piggy bank, CLSP, hex. And we're going to specify the arguments that we want to curry in. For target amount, we were using 500 mojos. And for cash out puzzle hash, we were using 0x cafe food. Oops, I used too many CLSPs. Now, let me go ahead and run that disassemble command again so we can see it side by side. You can see that this was our original CLVM puzzle, and this is almost exactly the same, but it's been wrapped in an extra layer, and we're actually now adding the cafe food and the 500 to our entire solution that's being passed in. It's really as simple as that. In fact, when we define def constants, it does something very similar. But what this allows us to do is now we have this generalized puzzle, we can have one unified file for our entire puzzle, and then whoever is spending the puzzle under whatever circumstances, whether it be a person, a program, or another puzzle, can set these values however they like. This is extremely powerful. I want to stress how important this is. Currying is what allows us to do the very common pattern of an inner puzzle and an outer puzzle. If we have a puzzle, we can adapt it to be an outer puzzle by adding extra solution values for the inner puzzle and the inner solution. If we have these as curried in, the inner puzzle is curried in, if we have the solution solve the inner puzzle, what we can now do is we can have our list of conditions and then we can just add to it the result of the inner puzzle run with the inner solution. And then now any conditions that come out of this inner puzzle will get added on to the list of conditions that we have for this outer puzzle. And then when all of the puzzles are done running, we'll have this big list of conditions that we can execute all at once. And then if everything is valid, it all checks out and we move forward. This is very important stuff, and it's very worthwhile to have a basic understanding of this concept before you try to build your first smart coin. Almost every smart coin that you try to build is going to have some need for currying, and so it's very important that you have a solid understanding of how this works and when you might want to use it before you go ahead and start building. Let me delete my inner puzzle modifications here. This right here is going to be our final and complete piggy bank coin. We're not going to be adding anything else. This is the final version that we're going to use. In the next video, we're actually going to be moving away from writing the actual Chialisp and start getting into some of the code that surrounds the Chialisp. If you have any questions about this concept, like I said, it's very important for you to understand it. Please head over to our Chialisp channel on Keybase and ask us some questions, and we will be happy to help you out. Until then, I will see you guys in the next video.